السلام عليكم. طبعا احنا جينا من العراق من مدينة اربيل الى الهند الى مدينة حيدرآباد مستشفى أشودة. هذا المستشفى انه وصفونا اياه انه بطب جدا راقي، وفعلا اجينا استقبلونا من المطار من داخل المطار وبكل حب وكل احترام، وقامونا بالواجب بداخل المستشفى وعملنا العملية إلى الشخص أخونا اللي عمل عملية مال إيده، والحمد لله تمت بنجاح جيدة جدا والحمد لله، وأفضل بكثير مما كانت عليه. فنشكر المستشفى وإدارة المستشفى ومن أطباء ومعنيين في داخل المستشفى وكل المستشفى وكل الكادر اللي موجود على تعاملهم الطيب والراقي معنا. فنتمنى أنه كل اللي عنده مرض أو شيء مستعصي أو شيء يأتي إلى هذا المستشفى، لأن صراحة أنا اللي شفته أنه بدون مجاملة وبدون أنه فتشي أو دعاية أو شيء لهذا المستشفى، لا، بس هذه حقيقة، لأن أنا أكثر من مرة جاي إلى الهند، فهذه المرة جيت وطبعا كله علاج، أجيب أشخاص إلى هنا علاج، فهنا المستشفى كلش راقي والناس طيبين اللي بيه والتعامل كلش حلو. وشكرا لكم.
Hi, I am Dr. Shashi Kanth. I am a senior consultant orthopedic surgeon working in Yashoda Hospital, Somajiguda. Today I would like to discuss or let you know about a patient of mine who had come all the way from Iraq with a problem in his right elbow. The gentleman, Karduk Abdullah, is a middle-aged gentleman who works as a teacher by occupation. He has had an injury to his elbow about 3 years ago, and the fracture was fixed locally with K wires, and subsequently the wires were removed, and ultimately the fracture did heal, but he eventually landed up having a stiffness of the elbow. Though he was able to manage most of his daily activities, his job of a teacher was difficult with the stiffness which he was having in the elbow. So he had consulted me through video consultation from Iraq. He had sent me his investigations and scans while he was in Iraq, and we had discussed the various options that have been left for him to try and improve his elbow movement, and ultimately he landed up in Yashoda Hospital to have a procedure done for his elbow. So we had discussed the clinical condition of this patient. We have evaluated him with x-rays, CT scans, and we have found out that he has got stiffness related to his elbow joint, mainly because of soft tissue and bony component. We have explained the condition to this patient and took him up for surgery with a guarantee that his elbow movements are likely to improve, but they may not become completely normal, which he quite understands, because most of the cases of post-traumatic stiffness, the surgeries will make the elbow movement slightly better, but they may not be completely 100% back to their normalcy. So with this understanding, we took him up for surgery. At surgery, we have decided to do this procedure arthroscopically with a keyhole. So the advantage with arthroscopic surgery is it will be done with a small incision. The recovery will be quicker. The hospital stay will be less. So we managed to preoperatively, before the surgery started, he had an elbow range of movement from about 50 degrees to 110 degrees. He was able to reach up to his mouth, but he was not able to completely straighten his elbow. So with an arthroscopic procedure, we managed to release all the stiffness in his elbow to an extent where his elbow was straightening from 50 degrees to almost 10 degrees, short of full extension, so which was quite reasonable. So we managed to do it arthroscopically, but because of the bony block at the back of the elbow, we had to make a small incision to release that. So at the end of the procedure, we were able to manage to get a good range of movements for his elbow. He was in the hospital for a day because it was mainly an arthroscopic procedure. We discharged him the next day. The wound were healing well, and we started physiotherapy for him immediately after the surgery, which is the key aspect in these situations. So elbow stiffness post-operatively can be made better with regular physiotherapy, which he had. And I have seen him today, 4 days after surgery. The wounds are healing well. And I have given him advice to follow up with regular physiotherapy at his local physiotherapy center. And we will follow him up in due course of time. Thank you.